Let us begin this journey, right from understanding the ABC of Python. Let us first understand variables and object references with the help of an intuitive example. Suppose you are working in a shoe factory, and your job is to package and manage the finished pair of shoes. Since each pair is unique, you have to make sure the correct pair reaches the correct factory sales outlet. As an efficient manager, once you get a new pair, you pack them in the shoebox and stamp an unique identification name to it. To make sure it reaches the correct outlet, you place them in their respective storage racks. Now things are sorted for you. When your boss asks you to send a shoe pair with ID 123 to the outlet with ID X45, you will not run around in your storage room checking each and every pair. You will simply take out your register, have a look at it, and shout an order that the dancing pair has to be sent to the New York downtown outlet. Now, let us get into the real thing. What are variables and object references in Python? As you know, a variable is something that can change. It is a way of referring to a memory location used by a computer program. These memory locations can help you store values such as numbers, text, or other data types. You can assign a name of your choice to access these stored values in your program. For example, x equals to 65 and y equals to 35. Unlike other programming languages, there is no need to declare the variable type in Python. Python will identify 65 and 35 as integers and store them in the data type int. Have a look at the following explanation on your screen. Further, if we change the value of the variable y to 100, y will now store a value of 100 and not 35. To understand object references, if x equals to 65 is a Python variable, it can point to an arbitrary object. In this case, it is an int object and stores a value 65. But if x equals to 65, then the x variable will now point to a string object. If, along with x equals to 65, y is also assigned as 65, then both x and y will point to the same int object, which stores the value 65 at the same location and points to the same object ID. We will explore more of this in the upcoming IPython notebook. Now coming to operands, they are basically mathematical and logical operations we can perform on the numerical variables, such as addition, subtraction, etc. Here is a list of the built-in operands that Python supports. We will play with them in the upcoming IPython notebook. So stay tuned, and let's catch a Python for ourselves.